40 years ago, a group of conservative activists gathered at a hotel in Birmingham. They had come to hear a speech by the radical Tory politician, Enoch Powell.
We were the only camera team there.
Powell had kept the content of his address a closely guarded secret. No one knew they were about to hear the most controversial speech in modern British history. It would be called Rivers of Blood.
In this country, in 15 or 20 years' time, the black man will have the whip hand over the white man.
He's notorious.
Powell claimed mass migration would bring division and violence. Many dismissed him as a racist scaremonger.
Powell's big mistake was precisely to talk openly about things that the political elite had decided could not be talked about openly, which is why he was drummed out of political life in Britain.
Instead, the liberal establishment embraced a radically different vision for the country from that of Powell. Multiculturalism. But 40 years on, and in the wake of riots and terror attacks, many are now asking, was Enoch Powell right to predict disaster in his Rivers of Blood speech?
It is like watching a nation busily engaged in heaping up its own funeral pile.
Race and immigration were explosive issues. Enoch Powell deliberately lit the fuse. Rivers of Blood remains one of the best known, but least understood speeches of modern times. For the first time on television, we've assembled the recorded fragments of speech to better understand Powell's argument.
In this country, in 15 or 20 years' time, the black man will have the whip hand over the white man. Well, I can already hear the chorus of execration. How dare I say such a horrible thing? How dare I stir up trouble and inflame feelings by repeating such a conversation? My answer is that I do not have the right not to do so.
The issue of race was to bring Powell into confrontation with Heath. Powell decided to quote directly from the experiences with immigrants of his white constituents. Only parts of that polemical speech were filmed, but Powell has kept his original text. He began by attacking the Labour government's bill that outlawed racial discrimination.
The discrimination and the deprivation, the sense of alarm and of resentment lie not with the immigrant population, but with those among whom they have come and are still coming. This is why to enact legislation of the kind before Parliament at this moment is to risk throwing a match onto gunpowder.
Powell quoted a letter he said he'd received about an elderly widow living in Wolverhampton, the only white resident left in her street. He quoted from the letter, "She's becoming afraid to go out. Windows are broken. She finds excreta pushed through her letterbox. When she goes to the shop, she's followed by children, charming, wide-grinning pickaninnies. They cannot speak English, but one word they know, racialist, they chant."
They found their wives unable to obtain hospital beds in childbirth, their children unable to obtain school places, their homes and neighborhoods changed beyond recognition. They began to hear, as time went by, more and more voices which told them that they were now the unwanted.
I walked the streets with my wife and three children. We had nowhere to go. We spent a week at her mother's, a week at her sister's, nowhere at all to go. And eventually we found a place, a very dilapidated place. We're still living. It's 100 years old. The roof leaks. It's no good in this day and age for people living. And when I look out of my back window, there's blocks of flats and masonettes with black people in. I think that's wrong. I think that the ex-servicemen should get preference in this country and preference these people.
Those whom the gods wish to destroy, they first make mad. We must be mad. Literally mad as a nation to be permitted the annual inflow of some 50,000 dependents who are for the most part the material of the future growth of the immigrant descended population. It is like watching a nation busily engaged in heaping up its own funeral pyre.
Underlying Powell's speech was a deep-seated fear. He believed that immigration was fatally weakening the racial, religious, and cultural ties that had bound his country together for centuries.
Powell ended the speech with a quote from Virgil translated from Latin. As I look ahead, I'm filled with foreboding. Like the Roman, I seem to see the River Tiber foaming with much blood. It was that line, not filmed at the time, which gave the speech its Rivers of Blood title. As the storm broke in the press, the Times condemned it as an evil speech, and there were grain demands for Teddy to sack Powell from the Shadow Cabinet. And the Smithfield meat porters marched on Parliament with a petition.
There's 2,026 signatures here to say that Mr. Enoch's right, that we have the right to say who we like and who we don't like. This is not a racial problem. All we say is that we've got enough immigrants into the country and that no more should be allowed in.
Nobody had any idea that we expected it would happen. It touched the spring. A spring which vibrated in the hearts of millions of people in this country.
2,000 signatures in 2 days. The latest in the press, 88% of Slough people say they support Enoch Powell. 88% Slough people.
But I've achieved a good deal, and I hear my voice coming through in what is said, and I see myself being proved right. What I had to say about immigration, what I had to say about the nation, what I had to say about Europe was heard and is still echoing.